Change! You got change! Ah, come on, help a guy out! Have a heart, would you?
Don't mind if I do. Only the doctor and the clone remain. Tonight we end this.
This can't keep happening, you guys. This cannot be my life's work, reviewing shitty Final Fantasy games, because, Square, were you not content that you'd made one of the stupidest, most vacuous RPGs ever played in my life? But then, this year, you had to go and make this! And then, did you not feel you'd failed enough this year that you immediately turn around after making this and squeeze out one of the worst MMORPGs in history? It was so bad, in fact, that you had to go online and apologize to everyone who paid money for that piece of dog shit. I mean, the makers of E.T. the Extraterrestrial didn't feel they had to apologize. What the fuck is the matter with you? Don't even get me started on Final Fantasy X-2. Oh, believe me, its day is coming, but how do you sequelize a sequel? X-2? You can't do that! Okay, so for the first time in the history of the series, the characters remember they can do the same shit in FMV sequences they can do in combat, and Yuna flies away from the wedding by summoning an Aeon. How fast would that have solved Final Fantasy VIII if instead of talking to the sorceress, you just pulled a Doom Train right up her ass? Cause that would have been fucking awesome. You end up following Yuna through the next Cloister of Trials, which apparently is in the world of Tron. These aren't even hard, they're just tedious and they go on forever. You've got this thrilling chase scene, exciting stunts, a tense battle where you crash a wedding, a death-defying escape, and you follow it up with a boring, repetitive conveyor belt and block-pushing puzzle. I know I've said this before, but this religion is stupid.
Hey! You can stuff your taboos!
Yuna and the others make it to the Inner Sanctum and get the Aeon, but, you know, the problem with going exactly where your enemies expect you to be is, did anyone have a plan? I had one. It was called running away!
You waste your breath.
So they get arrested and put on trial for heresy. Yuna tries to explain that Seymour's one of the Walking Dead, and that he's a liar and a murderer.
Maester Seymour is already dead.
Hmm? Hadn't you heard?
Wait, I mean, I plead the fifth. Not guilty! Damn it! You're on trial here! But it turns out, are you sitting down, that the entire Church of Yevon is corrupt, responsible for brutally enforcing a doctrine of misinformation, inquisition, intolerance, poor education, and inflexible dogma to amass wealth and political power for an inner circle of creepy perverted sex zombies at the top.
Resisting its power is futile.
From this time forward, you will service us.
Naturally, they're all found guilty and sentenced to being tossed in a pool!
Think they expect us to give up and die down here?
Ugh, well that's a lame way to kill someone.
Yeah, they get thrown in the fucking sewers again, or an aqueduct. I don't even know what this place is supposed to be. Is this the preferred method of execution for heretics in Spira? Being thrown in a pool with all your weapons and equipment? Then the bad guys start to arrange a zone defense at all the exits in case they escape.
Place guards at the exit, kill any who emerge.
Ah, the plan's all coming together. After the wedding, the public trial, and grisly execution of Yuna. Truly, this will unite all of Spira in joy!
I will go too.
You do not trust me?
Would you trust a man who murdered his father?
What are you, a Bond villain? Line them up against the wall and put a fucking gun in their mouths. They've already killed monsters the size of a fucking oil rig. Yeah, I don't think this place is exactly on par with the Rancor Pit from Return of the Jedi, when the most fearsome monsters are the same scowling scoops of evil ice cream we've been fighting everywhere else. The most dangerous part of this dungeon is that I have to use Riku, who would suck even if I had bothered leveling her narrow ass up. Oh no, a giant dragon! I take it back! This is the terror of the Via Purifico, the Reaper of Souls! What are we gonna do? Oh, just throw a phoenix down at it. Yeah, to put that in perspective, that's like me going up against Darkseid and beating him with a can of Red Bull. Seymour arrives and gives the same rambling, nonsensical speech virtually every Final Fantasy villain spouts, about how he really just wants to end all suffering, and if he kills everyone, nobody can suffer, and how much sense does that make when you're ending all suffering by devouring all life with a fucking Cloverfield monster? Ah!
If all life were to end in Spira, all suffering would end. I will destroy Spira! I will save it!
Blah blah blah, death and suffering and pain, for fuck's sake, man! Buy a Stabbing Westward CD, buy a comb! Shut the fuck up!
I will give you your death. You seem to want it so.
Even though you've already defeated me numerous times, this time you stand no chance, haha. You know, this guy gets stronger the more he completely fails. He's like Uwe Boll. So you beat him again, and does anyone think to do the sending ritual on his ass this time? Well, actually, of course not! Fuck, this game is stupid!
I felt like I should do or say something. Anything.
After that, you go to the Great Plains, where there are even more frowny ice cream scoops. They decide to go to Xanarkand, which is exactly where the villains wanted them to go, but why should they start acting intelligently now? But first, Tidus and Yuna have a tearful reunion, and then a disgusting sex montage. Oh, God. Oh, this is vomitous. The mere thought of his pale, narrow ass thrusting up and down, his bizarre gremlin-like O-face. Ladies, do you think you could live with yourself knowing that your first fuck was this guy? Now, for all time, Tidus is going to be her benchmark for sex. How much you want to bet he tried talking in all sorts of weird, perverted sex shit, like, bend over and let me pee in your butt? What? It's perfectly normal. All the chicks do it. At least they do in my Xanarkand.
Maybe just a little.
Then you go to Mount Gagazet, home of the Ronso asses.
Gagazet is Ronso land.
Elder Kelk! Let Biron rend them asunder!
We crush enemies following behind!
Seymour attacks you again. What does that make, 4 times now? You really got to admire how his constant humiliating defeats never manage to get him down. Oh wait, actually you don't, because a villain who consistently fails and poses no real threat has no inherent drama. He's as intimidating as Team Rocket. When you finally reach the top, the group makes camp and repeats the entire intro to the game. Explain to me again the need for a framing story when it accomplishes nothing, and in fact, accomplishes less than nothing because it makes the story make less sense. Was it totally necessary that most of this game be told in a 30-hour flashback? Even worse, this whole narration we've been hearing was Tidus recounting the whole story to the same people who just experienced it. He's been telling people stuff they witnessed firsthand. They were there! When you finally get to Xanarkand, naturally there's nothing interesting to see there except, well, the Cloister of Tetris. The Cloister of Trial and Error. The Cloister of Trials. All you do, I repeat, all you do is run around and step on tiles, which makes a Tetris shape light up and usually makes all the Tetris shapes before that disappear. Then you step on another, trying over and over and over again, until you find the exact sequence that makes them all light up at once. And then you do it again about 3 more times, with progressively more complex sequences. And this all takes about 2 hours. When you finally finish, you reach the Chamber of the Final Aeon, which isn't exactly there anymore.
Lord Xeon is... his soul is gone.
You mean... there is no Final Aeon?
Yeah. I probably should have told you that before we wasted all day fucking around in this temple and fighting that dragon.
Someone's coming!
Well, all's not lost because apparently she can still get the Aeon if she deals with Lady Unalesca. Don't get it either. So they all go inside the inner sanctum to meet her. Apparently Unalesca's not a big believer in pants, or clothes of any kind. It kinda looks like Lady Gaga. Good lord, woman, put on some clothes! Aren't you cold? Although, I am starting to see why so many people join the Church of Yavin. Anyway, it turns out that you can still get the Final Aeon, but one of the summoner's guardians has to sacrifice himself to be its vessel.
You must choose the one whom I will change.
We've decided, Titus.
There must be a bond between Chosen and Summoner.
We've made up our minds! Kill Titus!
The bond between husband and wife.
Titus! Damn you, woman! Kill Titus! She also tells them that by defeating Sin with the final Aeon, that guardian will later become the next Sin, which is what happened to Titus's dad, Ject. But no! Everyone's finally realized that maybe blindly following religious dogma, especially when it comes down from zombies with antlers and kimonos, is stupid, and they refuse to sacrifice anyone.
The final summoning is a false tradition that should be thrown away.
So why the fuck did they come all the way out here?
This is my story. It'll go the way I want it, or I'll end it here.
It's not your story! Even Yuna's sick of hearing this shit by now. You're a fucking child.
If you want everything, you'll end up with nothing.
But I want everything!
Insulted that you won't kill someone simply because she tells you to, she abruptly becomes homicidal and attacks you, turning into a... Whoa. Wow. Am I the only one who sees this? Do I just have a really filthy mind? She became a giant vagina! Eventually, she ditches the pussy form and becomes a giant gorgon head with red snake eyes. Jeez, this bitch got issues. Guess she got caught in a bad romance. This is actually a challenging fight because she fights in a really weird fashion. She's all about the status effects, mainly hitting your characters with zombie and then healing you, which of course does damage. And you have to let her do it because she's the kind of boss who just kills you if you don't play it her way. Shin Megami Tensei has a lot of those kind of bosses. So don't heal the zombie because if you do, it makes her mad and she just kills you outright with the power of rock by summoning Mega Death.
Die, so does the final Aeon.
Let's do something more unbelievable. Destroy Sin. I don't know how just yet, but I'll find out.
Well, this being a Final Fantasy game, I'm guessing the master strategy here is to hit Sin a lot with swords until it stops moving, because that worked out so well for you the last time you tried. Oh, right, I forgot. That was a humiliating slaughter. And remember that other time when he completely eradicated a far more technologically advanced civilization and barely noticed it was even there? But oh, I get the plan. We're gonna fight it three at a time instead of having all our warriors fight it at once. See if he can go the distance. Test his conditioning. I'm sure that'll counter his ability to flatten entire cities with tidal waves and hurricanes.
You Yevons, spiral of death will consume us all.
Who's Yu Yevon?
He who crafts the souls of the dead into unholy armor. An armor called Sin.
Yu Yevon lives inside Sin.
Oh, okay, so all we have to do is defeat Godzilla with conventional weaponry and, for an encore, climb inside his carcass and have a fist fight with God.
You can't whack death on the head.
If he comes near me, I'm gonna rip his nipples off.
Okay, now, I remind you, as if I needed to remind you, that our army's frontline fighters consist of a stoner, an idiot, an underage girl, an undersized Wookiee, and a water polo celebrity. If I were assembling an army to go kill God, this is not exactly the assembled force that would make me cry havoc and let slip the dogs of war. I'm thinking more... oh yeah. Okay, that's not the entire plan. They decide they can sneak up on Sin and catch him unawares by calming him with music, and so they fly around the world telling everyone to sing his favorites. Yes. That's actually the fucking plan. They're going to defeat Godzilla by uniting the world in song. So they fly around the whole world telling people to sing Ject's favorite song.
Yeah.
If you like Kina Colada,
actually, I don't know. I always pictured Ject as a Jimmy Buffett fan.
Cheeseburger in paradise. Give an arm and an onion slice.
They attack Sin, who cuts loose with an enormous, spectacular, gigantic Kamehameha ultimate energy attack, so huge in its bigness it puts a hole in the world the size of a country, but oh, everyone's fine. Never minimize the effectiveness of just hitting the deck.
Every blitzer knows, when you got the ball, you gotta score!
Then they all jump off the ship and directly onto Sin. Gotta say, awfully good for a blind jump from a high-speed airship against a creature that could easily just move out of the way, and not knowing if the fall would kill you. You, even the pimples of Sin are bosses. No, it's sort of weird that they're trying to find a sphincter and a giant flying dinosaur to climb inside it, and it kind of looks like an evil blooming onion from Chili's. Evil blooming butt onion. Once you kill the butt onion, Sin crashes down to the earth in flames. Wait, how did they survive that? How did they get back on the airship? They were on Sin! They were there, and now they're here, and the thing, the fuck! My mind just collapsed! Then reality breaks, or time compresses again, or oh my god, it's full of stars, or something, I don't know. Then you fight Gamera, which is surprisingly boring and unrewarding, and oh, for fuck's sake, not this guy again!
Don't you ever give up?
Come on, man! It was funny before, but now it's just getting pathetic. This guy loses more than the Oakland Raiders. Loses more than the Washington Generals. How much does this guy completely suck? It finally occurs to Yuna to send the little pissant.
But even after I am gone, Spira's sorrow.
Yeah, that's good. Tell Hitler he sucks when you see him. I really hated this part that comes up next. Even for this game, it makes no sense. You're running around this area, and you can't leave until you collect 10 orbs to escape, as spikes of ice, or something, randomly jut up from the floor and fly up your ass. You wouldn't think it'd be too bad, except for the fact the camera hates you, and oftentimes you end up running directly into spikes your character really ought to see coming. Seriously, what is the point of this room? Is it supposed to symbolize something? Can someone explain to me why the spikes, if they hit you, you get attacked by enormous monsters instead? After all that, you finally encounter Jekt, and this fight is fucking metal. He turns into a giant dreadlock badass who pulls a sword out of his own chest to kill you. And the music sounds like a dog trying to sing Slayer. This fight kind of represents what I'm talking about, where the boss fights are really cool and challenging, but too bad the plot is beyond ridiculous and I can't possibly get emotionally invested in any of it. Jekt finally goes down and berates his loser son for crying.
You'll cry. You're gonna cry. You always cry. See? You're crying.
I do like how Jekt's last words to his son are about how much of a pussy he is. After that, you have to kill all of your Aeons one by one, because Yevon gets his power by infecting them and turning them into the next Sin. So that thing we were doing the whole game, you know, going on that sacred pilgrimage, several days of accumulated game time, all of it is rendered completely fucking pointless! It's not even interesting or challenging. By this point, all your characters do enough damage individually to kill your Aeons in one hit, so the whole thing is completely tedious. Titus turns to the rest of the party now that the final battle's upon them. Once they kill Yevon, they basically upset the balance of the universe because God's dead, but they put all the souls of the dead to rest once and for all. And that includes Titus, who's kinda dead, but not really. He's more of a group hallucination made manifest by the spirits of the faith in Zanakin. You know what? I don't give a fuck. You wanna know? Ask a fan. I'm sure he'll be happy to spend a day or two explaining how it makes sense.
After we beat you, Yevon, I'll disappear.
And now, the final battle! The group has battled all over the planet, fighting demons, dragons, monsters, unholy abominations, and finally we reach the ultimate puppet master, the demonic deity that's perverted the entire world in its image! This is the ultimate evil that's dominated the wills of men, leveled entire continents, brought the world to its knees, killed millions, and commanded the destinies of all life on Spira for millennia! And what the fuck is that shit?! That's it? What is that? What the fuck is it? You, Yevon, it's a fucking tick. It looks like something I'd win out of a Japanese claw machine.
It looks like it should be helping me write a form letter in Microsoft Word. I can't even begin to tell you in how many ways this boss sucks. It's so bad, I honestly believe it's a joke on the Final Fantasy fanbase, like they're making fun of you for coming this far. Never mind that we're never given a moment's insight into Yu Yevon's true agenda, his characters, or even his reasons for enacting this infinite cycle of misery. Frankly, it's impossible to lose here. Even if you die, somehow, your characters have auto-life cast on them, so they'll just get back up, but not that you'll need it. This boss is insultingly easy and helpless before you. All he does is cast cure spells on himself when you hit him. That's it. You can cast Reflect on him and he just heals you when he heals himself, and right there, the entire battle just falls apart. Or you can cast Zombie on him, which means when he heals himself, the cure spells do him damage instead. Why does he keep doing that? This guy is supposed to be an all-powerful entity? This fight isn't even fair. It's like my older brother punching me in the face with my own fist saying, quit hitting yourself. After all the awesome fights we went through just to get here, we're finally confronted with a magic deer tick that you can kill just about as easily as stepping on it. Or if you're any kind of decent level, you can probably just nail him in one hit with your limit break. And once it's all over, we have to say goodbye to Orin too, since he's also an unsent dead guy.
This is your world now.
Don't worry, folks. He's not really gone. He's just kicking ass in Hades Arena.
This is my story. And you're not part of it.
Did you forget who you're talking to? I am the Lord of the Dead!
Huh. No wonder no one wants to die.
Talk about letdown endings, though. Not only do we lose Orin, but this sniveling little skid mark doesn't get nearly the kind of painful, agonizing death he deserves.
Alright, fucker, prepare to die! This is my story you're making fun of, and Black Lantern Spoony says I get to harvest your soul!
Life's good to me sometimes. Excuse me.
Hey, are you even listening to me? I'm the star player of the Xanarkin Abes! Didn't anyone tell ya?
Uh-huh, that's good.
Ordinarily, I'd kill you with my water-filled sword, but for you, I brought the most destructive weapon known to man. Eat Blitzball, Jackhat! Huh? Hey, no fair!
Just like a dork to bring a ball to a sword fight!
I hate your stupid game! I hate your stupid laugh! And I hate your stupid face! Oh.
Look at you. Look at what's become of this show. You're pathetic.
No, I'm heavily armed!
I am a shadow, the true self. Everything was better before this became my whole life. Playing games, bitching about movies. Do you really call this living? Do you think the people who actually watch your shitty videos actually care what you think? No, they just enjoy watching you suffer. And now, I'm going to give the people their wish. Just who in the hell are you?
To us, man. This isn't what we started reviewing games and movies for. This isn't what you started reviewing it for. We did this just to have some laughs, to make other people laugh, to talk about and share our experiences with bad movies and games. Not to hurt people, not to kill people or rule the world. I'd like to go back to that. I mean, you're right. What happened to you was wrong. That's why I'm glad you came down, because
I was hoping after a good fight we'd hash it out and I could give you your Christmas present at last. That's why I want you to have this.
I don't even know what to say. Show already killed me once, you witless, soulless clone. Once I take your heart, I take your power, and I can be whole again. It's the only way.
Oh, you're right. We do need to be rejoined, but there's another way. Linkara, energize!
I'm the star player of the Xander Knaves.
I have a question, science-related. How do Blitzball players manage to hold their breath for 15 minutes underwater at a time? Well, since you're technically dead, I guess there's no harm in me doing a little autopsy. Whee! What? You were expecting maybe the Ghostbusters?
What's the status of the genetic merger?
The merger was completely successful. However, something has gone wrong. He's not where he's supposed to be.
But then, where is Spoonie?